They're supposed to be on the way.
We should have like 7 or 8, like just piling up.
No, I haven't given any away. I meant to use Tiffany's sheet of plastic, but I forgot, so we'll have to use that next time.
Smell of sugar paint.
So, basically, we're getting things ready for you. How was y'all's day? Bear with me because I'm working with all this for the first time, so hopefully I won't embarrass myself. Can y'all like see okay everything, all the things?
Every and all the things.
Yeah.
What is this one you have up here? This one right now.
What? This one.
Why is that?
I don't know. It's the intro page. It's supposed to be the intro page.
But that doesn't look good. That's like off.
Okay.
Why does it say subscriber and...
I don't know. You do this, and I'll figure this out.
Well, let me just look.
That looks fun, though.
Grab that and then just shrink it. I don't know why. There should be a video there. Why is there not a video there?
I can't tell you what was done without me doing it. My love. Better? No idea.
I don't know if I'm gonna like this. Like, not being able to control that.
Well, you can't do both. You're just gonna have to trust me to do it. You want to more focus on picking your colors?
I don't know if this is gonna work.
What's gonna work?
Me not doing that.
There's gonna be a time where you're just gonna have to trust me to do this. Yeah? Do what?
Can you hear us? Am I spoken? Alright, so I'm going to use a glow in the dark.
Janine, sticky is acceptable, as long as you're here. I trust you, E, you got this. I know, Becky. We got it. It's fine. The only thing is I might say that this needs to be raised some. Thank you, Judy. What's up, happy chick? I'm gonna raise this camera a little bit. Or do you think that's enough of the...
Yeah, it needs to go up because not all the time.
Yeah. Thanks, you guys, for being so patient with us while we figure this stuff out. Also no. Alright. Nope. Nope. Okay. Which way do I spin this to tighten it?
What's that?
Which way do I spin this to tighten it?
That way. No. Yeah. Just keep doing that. You're going to take it off. If you just need something, let me do it. Let's see it. Stop. Is this not? It should just go on there. Oh my God. I don't understand what you did. You took it completely off of there.
Oops. didn't know that I could.
Well, you just don't go and.
Let me switch this can before I make it all clean. There you go.
I cannot believe I did this.
Well, I didn't know that you could.
Well, that's why you just don't, you know, start doing something you don't know.
Sorry, y'all. I didn't know that this was a thing, and I may have messed it up just a little bit. You need to hold something? Ah. Thank you, Jenny.
How does it sound? How does this sound?
Does it sound okay, y'all?
I'm gonna do it to where it's facing forward.
Everybody says it sounds fine. Sounds good, sounds great. Yeah, it's fine. Loud and clear, sounds good. Thank you so much, Lillian.
All right, so what am I gonna pour? What am I gonna use here? I wanna use like just all different kinds of colors. I wanna make a galaxy.
So you're probably gonna use that black, which is over here.
Well, I don't wanna cover it. I wanna use that as the base.
Okay. I would use that black, this white, a deep blue, a sparkly blue.
But I want to make it like all the colors.
You can make it all the colors. Really appreciate that, Lillian. That's for your smile. Thank you. Really appreciate all y'all tuning in to see what we're doing.
Show them bibs.
The bibs?
The aprons. The apron channel.
Oh, the apron spring. Jeb was playing with these little... I can do this. Jeb was playing with... some these things today.
And check it out.
She wanted to show you how this looks. Looks like this.
See what they're saying. This, what do you call it, canvas? We need to start taking care of our colors. Then they can't see the names of them.
Need more light. Love my apron. We'll have the other ones picked up today. Nope. Tomorrow, hopefully.
No, don't turn those on. What's the problem?
It's too dark.
Then turn that up. I don't understand how it's too dark. That's the look. Hold on.
So you guys, did you have a wonderful weekend? It makes me look more tan. But I'm not fooling y'all, I'm sure. Yes, neon glow in the dark tonight.
Put that over there. The chat. I don't think it's dark. It's the look I'm going for. I'm more of a, I don't want it all bright and gnarly.
I think ultimately, as long as the colors look true on this, everything else is secondary. Thanks for being so patient while we figure out the lighting and how to work these cameras. We've been working with them for a total of 3.5 days. The lights, 2 days. Lisa. It's just a little dark over the table. They said it's dark over the table. It's really hard to get the proper lighting and not have like glare lights, because then it'll give a weird reflection on here. So. Hi, Buttercup Mikal.
It's gonna be more clear than anything.
Edward, I'm sure multiple streams are killing the bandwidth, but we should be having fiber in like a minute. That's a lot of colors. The light behind him is distracting. Thanks, Trudy.
More light, no light. More light, yes light. What's up? What's all the lights?
So, we're going to go with this light until we figure it out tomorrow. This is the only shot I really cared about being 100%. I want this to be bright, so. This. I'll turn that down a little bit when you start pouring, yeah? Is that how to fix that?
So we're gonna use these.
You need the overhead? I think it might be too blown out for that. Yeah, it's too blown out for that. Let's go to the color can. Where is the color can?
I don't know if that'll work either.
I can see that one better.
And it's darker. These are from Art and Glow.
Hi, Shai.
And they're super sick.
They are from Art and Glow. They're very, very amazing paints.
This is green.
So, we've used Art and Glow a few times, and they have a really good resin that we like to use for our waterfall pours. And when you do use glow powders, first of all, use the powder and not the like liquid. First of all. Second of all, use
it's just too...
It's too bright.
I don't know if it's just because of that black paper too.
And so use a powder over the liquids, and you almost have to borderline on using too much. Typically, you want to use 10% of the amount of resin you use. You want that to be your color, 10%. And you really have to flirt with it being almost too much when you use glow powders. Also, I would mix these into anything opaque.
Yeah, probably. I wanted to show them that. This is what I did. What I drew on it. I drew with the stir stick and let it dry, and then drew on it with light blue chalk. Pin.
Thanks, Marcy.
And gold. Oh, there you go. You can see the gold.
Deborah, I'm going to be using Stone Coat Art Resin for my geodes. This is true faith. The color looks good on that beam.
And you guys got to see this in person. And this is for sale if somebody's interested in it. I love it.
Congrats, Jenny June Moonwalker.
In person, you can see all the little lines that when I drew on it with the stir stick. It's a nice piece. Where is my...
Marcy loves it.
Thanks, Marcy.
Do you buy Art and Glow through Amazon, art supply stores, or direct from Art and Glow? We buy direct from Art and Glow.
We have a link down there in our description. They have good resin for like quick.
But for some reason it ships faster from Amazon. To be quite honest with you, I send them an email. Since we're affiliated with them, I'll send them an email when we order it. The first time I ordered it, it was from their website, and then I found that I could link them through Amazon. That is in the description box below. And
yellow.
Do you want a yellow?
Yeah, I want like a bright yellow. Do we have a metallic yellow? All these are metallic.
I thought you were using gold.
I guess I could use gold, but I don't know. I guess I'm just seeing like yellows.
I don't think we have a metallic yellow. That doesn't look like a honey.
Yeah.
Do you have a flood coat on top, Jeff? Yes, Natalie, that one has a flood coat on top of it.
Yes, it's super nice, super smooth.
Elizabeth, if you call Stone Coat or email them, they'll work with you to ship to Australia. Awesome, Poopy. I'm excited too, Erica.
I really have no gloves.
There's those hardy ones over there, the vinyl. That's it. We need to get more gloves. That's awesome, Jenny.
That stinks.
Absolutely, Marcy. Hi, Angela. We missed you too, Jenny. Rachel, the resin that we use always depends on what project that we're doing. Right now, we prefer Stone Coat for our art pieces. And everybody has their own favorites for whatever project they're working on. If I work on a countertop, I'll probably still use Stone Coat. They have a resin for everything, it seems like. And so, yeah, unless I find a better working resin, why not use the resin that works best for me? And right now that resin is Stone Coat. We have a lot of different kinds of resin, and if someone requested that we test another resin, or if another resin is sent to us to test for you guys, 100% we'll do it. But in terms of our needs, Stone Coat meets all of them.
It's true, it's very true.
That's awesome, Joe Fish. Oh, Rod, are you talking about over this painting? Like this one, or that one he drew on that he just showed you? Thanks, Rick. Oh, Art and Glow. Yeah, I didn't know that. I don't know where they all ship to. Thanks, Tracy. What's up, Laura Taylor? Trudy, the difference between Stone Coat art resin and Stone Coat countertop resin, from what I've read, is that the art resin has a slightly longer working time and is slightly less durable than the countertop resin, because the countertop resin is built to be most scratch resistant, most heat resistant, most chemical resistant, because it's going to go through wear and tear, whereas the painting isn't going to go through any, like, should just be hanging on a wall. There's no need for it to have all of that. Its main needs as a resin needs to be a working time, UV, VOC.
The DOC.
I mean, you know, it doesn't have to withstand scuff marks as much as a countertop, right?
When you guys get this black, you're going to be amazed. It does have a little odor to it, so don't be alarmed. It's not like it doesn't stink, but it's definitely, you can tell that it's ready to start working.
Thanks, Alicia. Edward says that and art resin are very unfriendly when it comes to customer service. You know, I've heard that before, and that's just sad. Everyone loves that black, and they should. It looks like tar is just spilling out of that. You should have another glove on.
No, I don't have one. So
I just told you that those
would be. You have two different kinds of gloves on, though, babe. White. I don't think I've used this white yet.
Thanks, Shy. I want that black so badly. It's bananas. I wish I had another word for that, but I feel like bananas explains it pretty well. It's bananas.
Yes.
So, Khaleesi, we spent the first 30 minutes of this feed trying to get lighting and angles right.
Just how you missed.
That's not all day.
Of the feed, if someone asks what they missed.
Yeah, you didn't miss much.
Sherry, that's what I've heard. It sounds like tester model paint. Let me know how the red base goes. Idea says the DOC is dope.
I met him. Don't be jelly. Alright, I need some. Here, I need to get under there. I need this. I guess I'll just use the rest. There's really not much in there.
That's what she said.
Mm-hmm. Are you gonna need a new bottle?
If there's some just resin right there, like just the resin, I mean, obviously, just the resin.
Yep. Let's just get this later.
Oh, there's some right there.
What do you need? That's basically empty. First. There's some hardener.
No, this is resin, babe.
These are all Part A's. Okay, so you need B's in the trap. Yeah, I got one of the lids mixed up. So, while he is doing that, I'm just going to show you guys the colors that we're using. Jeff is using that black base tint, which is also known as black base tint on Stonecoat's website. Are you going to use the white? Yeah. Also, white base tint. This white. Focus. Also, going to use Cranberry by Just Resin. I'm hoping you guys can see the labels. Emerald Green by Just Resin. Blue Sapphire by Just Resin. Saffron by Just Resin. Fuchsia by Just Resin. And then the Glow Colors by Art and Glow. They look like this. This one is the Aqua Glow. Are you using all the glows? This one looks like an orange glow, but they call it the red. And then this one is the brightest of the three glows, and it is green. Cautious of when you're mixing those because the mix, it's really loud through the mic.
Mm-hmm.
What good micro brands would you recommend that are good value for results? Is there a budget? Because I'm really partial to our brands that we use, the Artist Who, Color Obsession, and Just Resin. But you can also use Black Diamond has a good one, a good line of micas. Larez has a good line of micas. And you can even use like soap micas. Brambleberry has a good line. Is that the name of that one? I don't know. Jackie says, I'm 2 days late. Went to a Greg David concert. Took me 2 days to get over it. I'm 52 and everything hurts.
Did you get in the mosh pit or something?
You don't have to mosh to be in pain after a concert. If you go like hard in the pain. Oh, of course, share their name. Avoid Art Resin's tints. Yeah, I wasn't that impressed with the Art Resin tints. Those little ink bottles.
Yeah. Well, yeah, they're very transparent.
Just sent us a lot of micas, but we haven't really tried them yet. Oh, what was that? The Patties colors that came in the full jars. You know what I'm talking? Those ones? Those are good. Oh, dancing and lifting my arms.
It'll happen.
I still can't believe I called your name Natural Blankets or something like that. Natural Blankies. I think it's a good name though.
Someone you didn't even have to stir this black and it...
It just incorporated itself?
Yeah, that was crazy.
That's awesome, Marcy. Silk paints, that's cool. 20 by 20 canvas or box, Greg made or what? I have a gallery I want to pour, just need to prep it tight enough. This is actually a canvas. We just prepped it as per that video that I don't have the link for, but will. I'll figure out how to put that in the video, but this is a canvas that we prepped. Thanks, Keisha. Keisha Obby girl. How funny is it that Keisha is like an Auburn person and I'm an Alabama person, which Alabama is mid
you have no
state.
Alcohol. And all the rags.
The rags are over there by the stir sticks. Just don't stress out. Here's the alcohol. Can you get you anything? Hi, Simply Chevy Couture. That's a good name, too. Anyways, she's from mid... I thought you were about to squirt that on. Never mind. She's from mid-Alabama. No. I'm from mid-Alabama, and I... moved to mid Texas. She's from lower Alabama and moved to lower Texas. Was and are rivals. By the way, my team's gonna beat her team. I forgot to tell her that. In case you don't know, Alabama's gonna beat Auburn. Is eye candy more opaque or translucent?
Ever used them?
I think we have. I can't remember, Laura. I'll send you a text. I did not just get it done. However, I washed it today. So that's kind of like getting it done. Right? Happens twice a week. Thanks, y'all. So many Roll Tides in the bunch. Say it.
Say what?
Did y'all hear that? That's good, Sweet Pea. I can't wash my hair every day. Number one, I don't have that kind of time. Number two, pretty sure it'd fall out. Another Roll Tide. She said LOL. I love you, Keisha. This is real talk. We're fam. What is it? The house divided? The house divided.
For what?
For... That's what happens when you have, like, a household. And
oh, I know that. I thought you meant here. I'm like, what am I dividing? What is my dividing? Like, you're talking about somebody else.
I'm talking about the fam house divided. Like, as a whole, in general, everybody. Thank you, Sue.
Thank you very much.
I really appreciate that, Sue. House divided against self will not stand, but the rivalry will stand. That didn't even sound like words. Idea says Jeff is straight cripping tonight. LOL. What's up, LOC? Or Locke? What is that wrong? I don't know if that's wrong.
Locke is in here?
No. What up, LOC? Or what up, Locke? I don't know. Night, happy chick. Really appreciate that, Sue. Let's put this here. Oh. A house divided, as in a family home having rivalry team fans in it. So, for instance, Keisha is an Auburn fan. I'm an Alabama fan. They're rivals against each other. Therefore, it's a house divided. How much of the glow powder do you put in the resin and mist it? Here's the thing. Typically, the rule of thumb is 10% of your resin. That's how much color, pigment, powder, paste, whatever should go into it. Start there and then build it up. I can't give you an exact number of how, like, a percent or a ratio that we put into the resin of the glow, but it's at least a third more than the regular colors. Because you really have to saturate the resin with this glow powder to get it to be really glowy. Glowy? Not a word. We can make it a word. It's a word. Really glowy. I guess that's the end of that sentence. But the thing is, you really want to be careful. You don't want to add too much because then it will turn into marshmallow fluff and or alien string cheese. All right, bye, see me or simmy? Anyways, we'll try to make it to the other side of the country next time. No, Moo and Cujo are the same dog. He's Mooey and he's Cujo. Guns up all day. Go Tigers in the SEC. Y'all, now the house is really super ultra divided. Welcome, Pamela. Erica, how did you and Jeff meet? Is that me? I'll tell.
Yeah, you're the one talking. You talk.
We met through a friend and decided we were gonna break dance together. And then a friend requested him, and three friend requests later, he accepted. And then in and around that time, we met up at a pool party, and then we went to paint, spray paint. And we really got along, and we were friends for like months before we decided to make it a fish show.
Like, for real friends, like...
No ulterior motives.
She wanted ulterior motives.
I stopped him a little bit. It's recommended that you get your alcohol in gallon size. It's much cheaper. This is true. Is there a silicone brand you recommend for making cells? Don't put silicone in your resin. You're just asking for a mess and a half to do a top coat later. Let me get a different view. Ideas wants to know if I can really be girl.
Well, she could do the kid and play. We did the kid and play. She didn't break dance. She
was I top rocked. You don't remember. What? I did. You don't remember.
Okay.
I'll show you later. So you like him?
Yeah.
Pop. You go pop. Can you recommend an awesome green? Eva, send me an email about, like, give me a color that you're looking for in green, and I will tell you which one I think is the best one. Absolutely, CJ, I will follow up with that. Actually, I think I sent them to you direct myself. Did I send you a tracking number? If not, I'll check. I'll check, so I'll send it to you direct after. I swear I just heard you say you guys decided you were gonna break dance together, spray paint together, or do y'all dance and paint? We do all the things together. I'm pretty sure we hang out more together than some married couples. Like, what do we do not together? Can't think of anything. Idea said, Erica sent Jeff a note that said, do you like me? Check yes or no.
Pretty much.
And then I put him in my trunk. Hi, Dee. The Knolls. I can't hate on them. Cherry said my husband was supposed to be a one-night stand. That's awesome, Mary Jane. Do you think I should turn down this light a little bit?
Yeah. It could be.
Let's just try and see.
It's just gonna get dark right here.
Does it look better or worse on camera?
It's just bright. It's just because these colors are bright.
I'm sorry, Alicia. Can you repeat? How old are you guys? I'm 34, and Jeff is 40-something.
What? You don't know how old I am?
He's 43.
You're trying to make me mess up this canvas, aren't you? Mm-hmm.
tasted. There's a rose gold on there. So you like it? Oh, thanks, Casey. Yes, we are still working with the first batch. We actually just recommended someone to check yours out. Jeff actually knows how to break things. What is the one I'm feeling? It is a dive bar here in Dallas. No, Jeff was born in 1970. Hi, Barbara. Ooh, B, that looks really fun on camera. Very trippy right now.
I just ruined it.
Just huge.
In my head, it was something completely different.
You didn't tilt it.
Fully just went from one, like.
It's a canvas.
God. I knew I didn't want to pour tonight.
Char loves it. You'll recover it. Those colors are beautiful. Wasn't expecting that. It looks so cool.
All right, y'all. Calm down.
More white. It's a Monet.
I'm just not feeling it tonight, y'all. I've been working on this lighting and I was Whenever I start picking out or thinking about what I want to pour 5 minutes before, it never turns out right.
Right?
shouldn't have put that black in there like that. It just like totally muddied it up. I'm not happy with that. I don't like it when I make such small amount of colors on such a large canvas. I'm doing what I, like I just started doing this.
How hot is your studio? We try to keep it at 78. But it gets hot here. It was 111 today.
Not a happy camper.
The white looks like a unicorn. It looks like graffiti. Congrats, Michelle. Jeff, did you go against your four-color rule? I have the four-color rule. Hi, Greg.
I think I heat it up too much.
I'm getting on Match.com. My good friend just married a really awesome Colombian girl by like E&J, season 5. Good lord, I can even draw lines that smooth with a template and he's doing it freehand. Love the texture. Yeah, that looks cool. I think I might do a pour.
Yeah, you need to do something to make these people worth their time. I just want to pour this all in the molds. These are skull molds. Dark. We got these really cool skull molds. I just don't know how much it takes. Yeah, I know. We all have off days. But I don't like to have off days. I don't like it at all. How are you supposed to... pour it in here. She's over there painting a canvas.
Little mold. I just picked it up.
It seems like it would be full already. That's nuts.
Is it buffering right now, y'all? Jeff, I'm interested in getting some skull molds. Can you show us? We did one, and I don't know if you can see this little guy. But he turned out pretty cool.
He's solid. You should probably do a solid color.
Thanks, Lisa.
And that would probably turn out way better than...
When I did this one, I just poured it just directly in there. The hole's not big enough.
But how would you pour it directly in there?
Just small stream.
Oh, like actually...
Yeah.
For some reason, I thought you meant you picked up that...
Ah, y'all caught it. I'm so glad. Thanks, Dee. I got up today and washed my hair. Makes all the difference in the world. Are you going to show it with the black light? Did you put the glow colors in the...
Yeah. There's no way it takes this much. Like, that is just insane.
Yeah, it takes a lot.
That's nice. I'm a little black in there. There's no way.
That's what I thought when I was pouring resin into
like,
there.
It's like,
it's, I, no, no, I feel no, it's like locked it just, together.
How does it just keep pouring? Like, I don't
see a butterfly in the piece. Did it get to 117 today? I have no idea.
There's no way. I swear, it's like, it's gotta be coming out or something. I think it's filling up inside of there. I don't know what it's supposed to look like though. it's way too silly.
Do you have any more left over?
No.
Okay. So we'll just put these guys aside.
Ooh, I just want to swipe this all off.
No, it's not going to all of them. We're filling up a little mold.
I don't understand how it just keeps going.
Well, I'm going to go get my canvas and do a pour.
think I might be just hungry because all I had was today was some guacamole.
Fighting words. You said Jeff is a mumble rapper.
Yeah. Sorry, y'all.
Before I get clocked for this canvas not being solid one color, I meant to. How did you say I should make that color I liked? Teal and purple?
What I can remember, I mixed like a phthalo. I did teal, I did phthalo, and then I added a little purple. I don't know. I honestly, I can't remember. Like, I don't know if that was just making a brighter purple. I just added a brighter blue to a teal.
There you go. There's a fly in here. Oh. Get trapped in the resin. One, two, two.
Yeah, that does look dark. The main camera.
Yeah.
But I don't mind it. It doesn't have to be like all blown out.
You don't mind it be? I don't mind it.
Lisa? Big B.
I think tomorrow I'm going to try to do that feather pour or stone coats. Sponge technique, I think. Questions.
I'm gonna try something real quick.
Yeah, let us know if this works and what it looks like. Once you have that, you'll see this bell right here next to the subscribe. If you don't see parentheses around it, click it to make sure you see these guys. That makes sure that your notifications are turned. Dropping when we do that.
That's weird. Sorry, y'all. Guess that does not work. I tried to put a video in there. Did you guys see the video? Did you see it?
Oh yeah, feather pour.
Yeah, we can. We have a scene to where it could. It shows. What we did is we recorded how to basically go subscribe and then make sure that you hit the little bell to get notifications. We made a video to show people how to do that. And also a video on how to, where to look for the scroll down.
In the description box.
In the description box.
Also, so, okay. We've been getting hit up a lot from other companies wanting us to review their products that have zero to do with our work. I'm talking about a hose. A multi-tool with 87 different little attachment things. What was the other one? Oh, a phone charger. I don't know.
The screwdriver or the wrench or something.
Yeah, that was the multi-tool. And so, since we've been getting those like offers just to review those things, we thought we were gonna like be cute and put together an infomercial, like a 15-second. Hey, you guys, have you ever had to have a hose but didn't know what kind to use? Do you feel sad? Would a hose fix all your needs? Well, we have the tool for you. Anyway, something like that. Would that be weird? That'd probably just distract from the... Just put my elbow in resin. I want to know what they're saying.
Do the infomercial. I told you to do the joke. Well, we would review it, but just make it silly and...
It'd be a complete spoof commercial.
Like go to my friend Gabe's house. He just got a new house. And we would plug the hose in, and it's one of those...
Expandable.
Kink-free hoses is what it is. Yeah, as seen on TV.
Way as seen. All of them are like as seen on TV thing.
Only if related to R. No, it would just be something silly to review.
Not review for profit. They don't pay us to do it. But we're just thinking of a way to make a joke out of it. Because it's kind of absurd. Why would you... First of all, if you watch my channel at all, you know that we live in a loft. A.K.A. don't have a yard. Or hose outlet port. What is it? Como se dice... Where you plug a hose in?
Faucet.
Would it be considered an outlet? I don't know. So, there's that.
Water faucet.
Can't make it do. I got it.
We would.
All of them. I wish I could see what they're saying.
What was that?
Yep, it's red down there.
No, I was going to your phone.
Why?
Because every time it froze up, I think it's because if I try to work on it.
Sorry, y'all. I should have a regular internet soon. Let's hope.
You can't wait for that.
So tonight, I'm just gonna use this white to test and see if it's as amazing as that black.
Thanks y'all for being patient with us with this new stuff.
Is it because Jeff's messing with the connections or just the connections? Probably maybe a little bit of both. Our service isn't that great right now because they're trying to add fiber to the building, so our signal catches up and drops all the time while they're doing the install. Also, apparently while we try to like switch screens and all that, and add new scenes, it doesn't like it. So, we appreciate y'all being patient while we learn all the different things. Marcy?
deep.
Glasses, I feel like they're always dirty and they're so difficult to clean. Does anybody else have that problem cleaning their glasses? Like, I feel like they just, like, you have to get a brand new cleaner. Drive me nuts.
I love deep teals. It's probably one of my favorite colors aside from purple. It's crazy how all of these cameras look like the blue is a different color. For the record, this is most accurate to this color.
Yeah.
For the record.
There's just too many.
Can we see what they're saying?
I just, they were saying goodbye or hi to people. Trudy, let me see here. That's not a dumb question at all. Flood coating is...
basically what I just did.
Basically what she just did, but you want to put a lot. Like, what you're trying to do is... cover the entire, hold on here, basically what you want to do is flood your entire canvas. So it goes over the edge, all the edges, it covers everything. If you have little pits or if you've sanded it and want to make it nice and smooth, and basically you're just filling the entire top with resin so it's nice and smooth and looks good.
Flooded.
Said I need the hanging tough pants. Thanks. We got a couple new cameras and new laptop, and you guys are the guinea pigs. We appreciate your patience. If it's Ken said perfect, walk away. All right, calm down.
You got jokes.
Yeah, I'll get some of those.
love that little fade. One goes away, one comes up. That's fun. Looks real good. From Ocean. What?
They do look like little jellies.
Thank you, Ocean.
Thanks, Ocean.
Attitude adjustment fund. Now, I just messed up a canvas. Or I couldn't say that because you can fix it, but I did a really shitey pour. All right. So. All
right. What are you bathing now?
Lord have mercy on me. Gorgeous, Erica.
Thanks, y'all.
Just leave that. It looks great. So crazy, like that is a super deep teal, and that looks like blue on there.
Put it to one of the tri camera. Smell.
Tri camera?
Yeah, don't you have one that has like main, B roll, or the color cam, and overhead?
Like that?
Tries three.
What are you using?
Yeah.
Yeah, you see that? That's the bigger picture, that's the true teal. That's so crazy. I wonder why those are.
I do something different than my.
I mess up canvas all the time. Fortunately, 14 allergy people are not watching. I think there's like 156, but thank you. There's not 14,000. I think some of our subscribers are sleeping. We just got all this stuff, so we're just trying to
still working
out
on it.
Like, what I'll do is I'll probably just do all the settings for whatever I have on this for all the other cameras for the main, because that's actual true colors what you're seeing in hers. The big picture. say that.
So should I do something else to it?
I would leave it. Leave it. Everybody says leave it. Heidi says leave it.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm just going to have to put all the settings to this camera here. I think that would be cool. Yeah, that's a great piece right there.
Oh. Sorry about this guy.
Oh, yeah. Look how awesome that is. Look at that ring light just blowing out. Looks like a magic trick. Super nice piece. Yep, she's leaving it. She put it away. She put it away. Put it away.
Can't wait till our other
El Pistolero. It turned into a mud pit. I like strayed away from my what I wanted to do. I only been thinking about it like for 5 minutes before we went on. So I was busy all day messing with this stuff, setting up lighting, and yeah, it's just setting up every single camera angle the same. Just copy all of this. I'll probably just erase all these and just make new ones and just copy them all so they all have the same look. That should be cool.
Alright, I'm gonna pour over a trash canvas, and if you don't know what just happened, you take a canvas that you've resined over that you don't like. Mine happens to look like this. Yes, it is a big purple blob with some sparklies in it. And you sand it down with a 400 grit, take a 90 something or higher percent ISO alcohol and wipe it down. Good to go. Let it dry. The end.
The end.
I promise tomorrow I'll do a feather. Just tune in tomorrow.
Feather.
Slash someone send me an email and remind me so I don't forget.
Slash.
Now I just feel like Mike from Stonecoat when I like work the resin around like this. Gotta work it. Chop it up. Also, you got this. I have to remind myself of that sometimes, because sometimes I'm pretty sure I do not got this.
I don't know what happened to El Pistolero. My mind wasn't in it. I got it impatient and just started messing with it. So. What?
Got impatient and started messing with it?
That's what she said.
Yep.
Here, I'll do that. Don't grab that. You're gonna get
resin all over it, bingo.
Man, that is just so dark.
Oh, I had a flower.
I just been going all day, and I think I'm hungry. Hello, I'm really sorry for name being me. What is that?
Sorry for what?
Hours?
Huh?
B.O.B. Flame Shadow Wolf Girl.
Wow, awesome. BRB Flame Shadow Wolf Girl is just a name.
Yeah, it's not me, right?
Mm-hmm.
Maybe she meant the name being too long. I don't know. Gotta go, Night Owl. See ya, Trudy. Well,
mm-hmm.
That's fun.
An improvement on the way it was.
Yeah, I just want to get all these settings for main role. I'm pretty sure that's what that is. Yeah.
I think I might just leave that.
I'll just leave it. It looks fun. There you
it
go.
To be a little different.
I'm gonna leave it tilt.
And you know this. I'm gonna try. Okay, would it be tacky to add some of my glitteriest glitter in the whole wide world glitter?
Put it in the center, but then it would really be a flower. So I don't know.
Ask the people.
Lynn, what did she say? You're a portrait artist. Paint one of your beautiful Erica and you'll be ready to pour after that.
It's true. Paint a me.
Cute.
Should I add some this?
I get tired after I do a big piece. That's actually glass.
Pretty sure. Don't cut yourself.
Oh, it is. I mean, it's pretty
glassy.
Yeah, that's very, wow. I don't know, how would you do it? How would you put it on there? Hold on, let's see here. She's going to...
Thinking about it.
Thinking about it.
Okay, I'm going to see it in there.
I'll do all of it. It's so bright.
Just blown out. Try to be real.
Oh yeah, they can see that.
This is called the glitteriest glitter of all the glitter. But it's not glitter, it's like super fine shards of glass. Add it or not to add it?
Make a flower geo. No glitter. Terry says, no glitter.
Make a flower geode. Night Ocean, thank you.
Oof.
Flower geode.
Where are you going to swim? Do it. Do it. How are you going to put it on there? Like, are you just going to sprinkle it or have some direction with it? Does it sink? It looks like it's sinking.
I think it is sinking.
It might make it look a little funky.
Y'all, I was gonna, but testing it right here, it just sunk to the bottom of this resin. Just gave it a funky texture.
Yeah.
I think I'm gonna have to leave this one and save the glitteriest glitter ever, also called Diamond Dust. Can't see it. Maybe you can see it.
Thanks, Red Wolf.
I said bye, Ocean.
We just got these cameras and this laptop and this program and all this a couple days ago, so we're just asking everybody to be patient with us. And
I think it's an actual glitter.
Save it for another day.
I did.
Ellen, I did, but I poured it in one of these skull things. Hopefully that sets up tomorrow and we can take a look at it. Bring on the dancing crows.
Here, I'll get you guys a little closer.
Let's see.
Yeah, this is pretty.
A little better.
What about this glitter?
Mary Jane says, I think you should leave it. It looks beautiful.
Very subtle glitter from Stone Coats glitter line.
That's true, Terry. Practice does make perfect. Yeah, that's true, Judy. I didn't have my music on. I should have had some music on. Good night, Crystal Dawn. She's putting glitter on there right now, you guys. It looks awesome from the side, but it's hard to see it.
From the top? Where's the...
Art by Ketter. Is that how you say it? Ketter? We were saying Carter. Sorry about that, by the way. Ketter.
It's Dawn.
Yeah, Dawn. She says gorgeous, Erica. Let me see B-roll. Let's see. Can you B-roll? No, this makes it darker.
No.
You can't see it clear. You'll have to go from the side. I need to work on that to Be Real.
Should I try Be Real? Move it?
No, it's too dark.
Okay.
Like the settings are way too dark. Lucy said that's really nice. We can see it. Oh, there's, let me see the glitter a little bit there. Let me show it in that camera.
Okay, switch it.
1 second.
Watch it just all slide off. How cool is that though, y'all? I can go like this and it doesn't move. But I could heat it and completely rework it. That's so bananas! Watch. But. How bananas.
I would just leave it.
I just wanted to show them how you could do that. I'm gonna leave it.
Leslie says, looks great. With that stone coat and just resin. Yes, that was stone coat resin and just resin pigments. And
Artisu.
Oh, and Artisu.
And stone coat pigments and stone coat glitter.
Yeah, there was a couple different brands in there. Mary asks, are there any other resin newbies here?
Makes me think of a starfish. I can see that. Oh, I'm glad you like that stone coat. E, when are you going to do the shell pour? I actually have the base of the shell pour done, and let's plan that for Wednesday. Do we have something going on Wednesday?
Just be Wednesday.
Wednesday. Someone send me an email so I don't forget. Lars, we really are liking Stone Coat the best, for sure.
Hi. Let's see what Cujo has to you guys.
We'll do, Don.
Let's get him up close in the web, in the,
the that cam?
Yeah.
You're okay, Miz.
See? Right there. Look at right there. He's right there at the people. His hair.
Mm-hmm.
Miz. All the hair.
Is it about that time? Do you want to just go to the outside? Oh, no!
You're going to get hair in that.
Okay, I'll see that. Are you being a circus prom? I know. So calm down. We'll go in a second. All right, you guys. I hope you enjoyed our experimental day of resin pouring. Digging Stone Coat's resin the best, I gotta tell you.
Digging it.
Super digging.
Love it.
I don't have to read all this to you guys anymore. It's right there. But I'll read it anyways. So, if you have any questions, please check us out. We're over here in these things. Oh my God, how cool would it be if it like overlaid? Like if I could like doink, 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 doink.
Oh, I'm looking.
Doink. No, you need to put your finger this way. No. Yeah.
Oh.
This way. Anyways, that's all the information. If you have any questions, shoot us an email at thorn@artistillette.com. Okay. It's right over here. I'll figure it out at some point. And if you have any interest in these mystery boxes up here.
I don't think you can see them. Oh, yeah.
Or the stir sticks or the artist who paint, visit our website, artistilldeath.com, 2 T's, 2 L's, 2 N's, apparently. I didn't even know because there weren't. Anyways. And if you are interested in any classes that we have coming up, here's that.
Ta-da!
Our next one will be September 1 and 2. It will be a beginner's class. We also have beginner kits on our website at artistilldeath.com, 2 T's, 2 L's. And if you need any merchandise, we have shirts at Teespring. Wait for it. Click it.
Oh.
There it goes. Teespring. That's right here. That way. No.
Yeah, that way.
If you want to send any letters to us or have a product you would like us to try, our snail mail address is 1409 South Mar Street, 75215. Enough. He's going to pee on my feet, y'all. I'm going to have to take him out. Join our core group, ATD's core people, to get all the info on when we're going to go live, if we have to skip a day or whatever happens. If our time for live changes, check out that website. Also for the giveaways, sweepstakes, contests, competitions, and all the other similar words for that.
Yeah.
And if you're interested in some stone coat, this is really important. Use the code capital ATD, however the D is that you like, whether it's this way or this way, I don't know. And that will give you $30 off an $80 order so that you only have to pay $50. Bananas, that equals 2 free metallic paints if you're counting. And if you're interested in just resin, use the code ATD. And it will give you 1 free mystery paste for every $100 you spend, 2 free mystery paste if you spend $200. And I think $200 is what you, that's when you get free shipping. I don't know, I'll check for sure. All of that is in the description box below here. Yeah, it's in there, it's down there.
I would show the video, but
it'll drop the feed.
It'll drop it.
I gotta take him out before he pees on that beat. We love you all so much. Thank you for watching. We couldn't do any of this without you. Y'all mean the world to us. Be kind to each other. And we'll see you all here tomorrow at 8 p.m. Central Dallas, United States time. Bye.
I said bye.
You say bye?
Bye.